Well, what is going on? Welcome back to Clayton Schick Outdoors. Of course, I'm Clayton Schick. This is the beautiful, beautiful outdoors. That's Carter Reed right there. He will be fishing with me today, not in the shack, but separate. Hopefully he slams some kind of monster. We can put him in the video as well. But I'm fishing, or we are fishing, at gorgeous Lake of the Prairies, staying over at Lost Meadow Resort, right on the lake here. Picked up some live minnows. We'll check into our cabin here at the end of the day, but it's one of my favorite places to stay. It's so centrally located throughout Lake of the Prairies. You can fish the north side, you can fish the south side, you can do whatever. Today, we've got the trailer, unloaded the Ranger, and we're headed out to some favorite spots. I'm gonna be using the Humminbird Fish Smart app on our phone. We already have the chips loaded on the Humminbird 2, Carter's Helix 7, my Mega Live. In terms of that, the card's loaded, but we're gonna pick some humps allocated close to the river channel and set up probably for the day, and hopefully we can get some action on the underwater camera. So we got lots to do yet. The sun is not quite rising, just starting basically. And yeah, we'll get out there, get loaded up, and or get set up and get fishing. Let's do it. Well, I tell you, ice fishing is a lot more work than in a boat, especially filming, like a lot more. Carter has picked a spot. He's already set up, he started to fish. I've just kind of found, I think, where I want to be now. I was using the Mega Live here a little bit, looking around, kind of on top of a hump. I already knew that from the Fish Smart app, but I really wanted to just get a good look down there. If it wasn't so cold, I'd pull out the underwater camera and have a little peek too. But right now, we just gotta get focused on setting up. It's chilly, minus 23, I think, Celsius right now. So it's gonna feel good to get the otter popped up and the heater going. So I guess we should work on that. Let's do it. Oh, I have a fish coming on the bottom. I can't see him on the camera yet, but I can see him on the Mega Live. Here he comes. Okay, I'm gonna see him on the camera right away. Come on, where is he? Here he comes, there he is. He took a swipe at it. Man, I'm so far away, I've got amazing footage here. He took a swipe at it, but it didn't hook up. It's gonna come back. Man, I'm like so far. Oh, here he comes, here he comes, here he comes, here he comes. Here he comes, or another one. Come on, come on. I'm so far away from my underwater camera. Everything's still foggy here on the main camera because I just got set up. Come on, come on. I can't believe the visibility, it's pretty awesome. I'm about 8 feet away right now. Come on, buddy, come back. Here he comes. Come on, come on. So I'm torn between turning the camera and getting this in the middle or whether capturing both. I think for now I'm gonna capture this bait and the live minnow, and then if I get lots of action here, maybe I'll kind of turn the camera. But this is awesome. I completely realize that the underwater camera and the Mega Live is completely overkill, but I want you to remember, I do it for the viewing pleasure. You can use just a normal flasher and you would be very well off out here. I do this for the viewing pleasure, and of course you do learn more from it, right? Like I learned from that underwater camera right there that I shouldn't have dropped it on top of him. I should have known better like that. It's hard to see that on the flasher itself. So, silly Clayton. Silly, silly Clayton. We got Carter set up in the otter over there. We got Carter set up in a flip over. I do have a GoPro running for him there, and I got him mic'd up. So hopefully.
Clayton, big!
What? Big?
Big!
Coming! Carter just said we got a big one. We're going over there. Unbelievable.
Huge! Boy.
What?
Huge!
Okay, did you land him? Land him and keep him in the water, buddy! Oh, yes, Carter Reed. Yes, Carter Reed.
This is 30. This is 30. It looks big. Come in the door with the GoPro.
What?
I don't have them yet. This huge, Clayton.
Okay. Okay. Go easy. Go easy.
I got him. I got him.
Yeah, buddy.
This is huge.
On the dead stick,
yeah.
Awesome. Awesome.
Carter, that's a 10. Like, that's big. Look how fat it is. Oh, that
my
is
guess
a
is
big.
29.
It's probably definitely, I'd say 29. Awesome. Oh, 20, 29? Yeah, looks like 29.
Yeah.
29. Not a boy. 29 incher. Deadly. Oh,
PB okay. through the ice.
PB through the ice right there. So Clayton knows how to find some fish for you, hey? Unreal. Let's get her back. Deadly. I'll grab the board for you here. Fire it down. 29, buddy. Ate the live minnow, hey?
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Get it just a little bit. There she goes. Dude, midday.
Just I went like for mine. The grab.
You had to.
Yeah.
That a boy. Epic. Well, that was epic. I just got back in here set up. I'm pretty sure I was talking about having Carter set up in the flip over and I put a GoPro there. I'm so glad I put a GoPro in there for him. Have him hooked up to audio, everything like that. Like, that was not staged at all. Unbelievable. He said that he was working his tantrum and it went at it a little bit. Or didn't went at it, but interacted with it and then left and went over to his dead stick, which is what I got going on here too with a live minnow, and ate it. So I'll show what he was using here at some point in the video as well, or what he caught it on, the setup that we use for live minnows here. But unbelievable. What a start to the day. Hopefully it continues. Like, that's epic. Truthfully, I'm so glad he caught that fish and not me. Now I'll catch a 30 incher and be pumped, but the last time we were out, I caught the 30 incher and he watched me catch it. I'm glad it was his turn to catch one. So it's pretty cool. Oh, here comes a fish on the left. I like to be able to see it on the Mega Live before he even gets to the underwater camera. He's coming in pretty quick, 10 feet. I'm gonna see it on the camera right away. Here comes, it's two of them, I think. Here comes. Come on. Come on. Here comes. Here comes. Oh, just little guys. Come on. Come on.
There we go. Nice.
I just pounding it on a spot and just kind of letting them take turns, and they were just kind of coming up at it, crashing at it. Nice eater right there. Nice eater. Carter catches the big fish, but I caught supper. That's probably the most important one right there. You're gonna taste good, my friend. So like I was saying, I just pounded it on the spot. I don't know how good it's showing up on the underwater camera for sure. Maybe I should be a little bit closer. It's hard to tell. I'm only watching on a little screen. You guys are gonna watch it a little bit more blown up type of thing. So I'll know when I get home, but I can definitely see the fish a little bit. Not great, but I won't know for sure until I get a review of the footage and then make an adjustment from there. Maybe move the camera closer next time, figure it out type of thing. It's a trial and error thing over and over again. Oh, here comes a fish. Coming to the live mill. Oh boy. This is a walleye, it's big. It's big. It's big. Come on.
Yes, that's a big fish. That's big. Unbelievable, I saw it come on the Mega Live first, and then I looked down, it was on the underwater camera, and I'm like, yeah, that's a big fish. Is it my turn now for a big one? Oh, baby. Oh, baby. Yeah. Yeah, this is big. This is big. I feel like I got a good hook set on him, too. I switched over to a dinner bell. Oh, it's right here. It's right here. Oh, it's right here. It's big. It's big. It's big. It's big. It's big. Come on. Come on, baby. I don't think I'll lose it if I just... Go slow, Clayton. Go slow. Breathe. Breathe. Oh, yes! Unbelievable. Oh, baby. Monster. Unbelievable. First Carter. I have another one coming to the dead stick now, too. Unbelievable. I'm not even gonna mess with it. Carter's got the measuring board. It's probably 28, 29, something like that. It's a tank. Wow, what a day we're having. Unbelievable. Oh, that was epic. Oh, just soaked everything. That was unbelievable. That was unbelievable. I knew it was big when I watched it on the Mega Live cruise in. I wasn't sure if it was a pike just for how long it was. Like, it was big on the Mega Live, and then it showed up in the underwater camera, come straight to me, twitched it above. The bite's been so finicky. I've been trying, I tried a rattle bait for a while, tantrum, I tried hyperhammer from Acme, and then I went to the dinner bell. I think when the bite's really, really finicky, obviously you're better off with like something that's not as flashy, something that doesn't move around as much. And I tipped it with a minnow head on the hook. Again, I don't like to use bait all the time on spoons, but when it is a little bit finicky, like it seems right now where fish are just coming in, taking a little nip and then leaving, or coming in and circling and stuff like that. So I think as the day progresses, I'll be able to switch to a more aggressive bait. But the good old rose gold dinner bell, baby. I'm still waiting for my insanity peppers. I probably would have caught 30 fish by now if I would have had my insanity peppers. When I get those things, look out. It's going to be money. Oh, here we go. Here comes the marks from the right. Coming in pretty quick, too. I'm just going to keep doing what I'm doing here. Oh, yeah, it's coming in fast. Coming in fast. Another nice fish. Another nice fish. So it comes, I'm going to start to pull it up. Oh, that's another nice fish. Nice. That's another nice fish. Not as big as the last one, but still another nice fish. Wow, we are on the spot right now. Carter and I are definitely on. Oh, I dropped him. No. So Mark, see it moving on the bottom. Tight to bottom on the left here. It's coming in fast. Oh, it's screaming in. Scream. Oh boy. Oh, that's a pike. Get out of here. Get out of here. Oh no. Get out of here. I don't want to lose my dinner bell. He was going to go to the live minnow, isn't he? Look at him, he's coming to the camera. Should have known how fast he screamed in there. Should we catch him? Or should we mess with him more? Look at him, look at him. He's coming to the camera. He's like, oh, it's you. He's checking out that camera big time. That was awesome. See if he turns around here. Well, I got some smokies on the grill. Carter cooked up smokies first, and now I got the grill over here and I'm cooking some up. Life's good. Life is really good. So far, slow, but we got the right fish. Carter got a 29. I caught one that was probably around that 29, maybe 28 type of thing. Big fish. One other little guy so far. And a pike, but it also is the slow part of the day. I find Lake of the Prairies, you can really have your prime time bites, especially in the sunset like that. 4 o'clock to 6 o'clock, somewhere in there. Even just after the sunset's gonna be lights out. It's pretty amazing. So it's like you could come here, stay at Lowen's place at Lost Meadow, go out for the morning fish, come back to the cabin for a few hours, have a lunch type of thing, and then head back out for the evening again. Lowen does rent shacks right out there as well, and he'll drill all the holes for you, get the fire going in the morning, so you could just kind of roll out there and start fishing. If you don't have all this equipment to bring out, he does have shacks for rent, and I've stayed in them before. I've used them before. They're awesome. He's got wood in them, wood stoves type of thing, and super warm. Instead of cooking smokies on the buddy heater, you could cook it right on a nice cast iron frying pan, something like that, right on the wood heat. It's always that's always the best, like deer sausage in a cast iron pan. Like, how amazing is that? Oh, it's the best. It's the best. But yeah, so far a little bit slower. I expect there to be a really good evening bite. I'm thinking probably around that 3:30-ish, somewhere in there, is when we'll start to see lots of marks cruise in. I hope. You never know, right? Fish can go and get weird moods, and you could just have nothing go on that evening either. But lots of times, if you're set up in the right spot, I like to set up, or here comes a fish on the right. I like to set up on this lake pretty much anywhere off the river channel or anywhere near shore where you have a really sharp drop off. like right here where I'm sitting in 25, 26 feet. And just to my right, about 25, 30 feet, it drops off into 35, 40 feet. So I do like to stay just a little bit out of the river channel or off the river channel for the most part. But you can find any little nook cranny in the river channel or bend type of thing. Shorelines are always productive. You don't have to be near the river channel. But yeah, it's just such an amazing lake. I love to fish it. I love to fish it in the summertime. I love to fish it in the wintertime. And it's definitely worth the trip out.
You hired before.
Right. So. Right.
Yeah.
Oh, I just finally caught a fish, Rocky.
Did
you? Yeah. Underwater camera and everything. Yeah. There. Now you can tell your boys, Rocky, you're going to be in a CSO video. Yeah, you got it. You got into a video before them. Just caught a nice eater. Maybe I'll fry them up and bring them over. Come over here. Oh, here he comes. Come on. That was awesome. He took two cracks at the live minnow first, but dropped it. And then he came over the dinner bell, and I got him. We'll get rid of this guy. Get rid of this guy because I think he's on my live minnow. Oh, he's definitely thinking about it. Oh, there he is. Got him. That looks like a better fish too. Looks like a decent fish. Nice. That's what you call a double header, baby. Yeah, this one feels nice. This is such a good rod for the dead stick. Easy, buddy. Where are you? Feels nice. Where are you, buddy? Where are you? I haven't seen him yet. Definitely feels good though. Oh, that's a nice fish. Not giant, but definitely nice. Nice. Come on, buddy. Come on. Oh yeah. You fell victim to the live minnow, didn't you? Well, that's a nice double header right there. About a 22, 23 inch or something like that. First one was like 18, 19. Beauty double. So at Lake of the Prairies, you can use live minnows. I get my live minnows right from the low one at Lost Meadows. And then what I use here is a tungsten bullet weight right there. Stop being so, there we go. And then a little bobber stopper right there. And I run about on a, probably about a foot length there for a leash. I call it a leash from the bobber stop down to the minnow. And I hook my minnow just right behind his top back fin, basically. And I drop down there and I watch on my graph. I keep probably the weight about, I'd say about 2-3 feet off bottom. That way the minnow can't quite get to bottom. He kind of just swim around there on his leash. And I like to run that on a 39 inch Frostbite drench, it's called. It's a fiberglass rod, bends pretty far into the blank. Gives you an awesome rod for dead sticking walleyes. Oh, there's a fish on there right now, actually. There's a fish on him there right now. Is he coming to it? Is he gonna eat it? It's a really, really good dead stick rod for walleyes. I find the drench. Fish is coming right up there to it. See, look how he just ate it. Now it's starting to load. I got time. Bang, pull up. That's a nice fish again too. We're on some pretty good fish right now. The drench is such a good dead stick rod. I love it. I'll go through my combination, what I use here for rods. For my top, oh, he's so head shaky. My top three walleye rods. Oh, baby, that's a nice fish. But the drench for a dead stick is definitely really good. Really, really good. It's another nice quality fish. Like, I just got back down there. Just. Wow. We are smashing nice fish right now. Smashing. He pounded that minnow, didn't you, buddy? Didn't you? We just got back down there and leveled another one, like another 23-ish. Oh, there goes my head camera. That's okay. I don't need it right now. Back down you go. See ya. Awesome. Well, that was fast. So I talked about the drench a little bit. That's my favorite dead stick rod for walleye. Hands down, fiberglass bends further into the rod blank, so the fish doesn't feel anything when he picks it up. But my other go-to walleye rods for in the shack fishing, the smoke show, which is a 37 inch medium light, and the True Grit, which is a 38 inch medium. And I kind of put my smaller baits on the smoke show, and I put my little bit medium to bigger baits on the True Grit. That's my, like, my 1-2-3 punch when it comes to walleye fishing: the drench, the True Grit, and the smoke show. These both are graphite rods, a little bit more sensitive to feel. You can feel bites a little bit easier. And then, like I said, the drench, just because that rod loads so far into the blank and it gives you time to get over there and grab it. The fish grabs it, doesn't detect anything, and starts pulling down. Everything seems normal. You grab it. And then it's like almost too, when you grab it, you just kind of finish the load, right? You don't have to have this giant hook set with this, especially with the live minnow. Just kind of finish the load. As it's starting to go, just let that rod just kind of load up all the way into that blank and kind of seal that deal with that hook. Sharp, sharp hooks is super key with that. I don't want to see a giant hook set with those. When a fish up bites you like that, like on a screen, like some have been up biting, you have to give them a pretty good hook set with this, because the fish already has forward momentum going upwards. So give them a good hook set in that, with that sense, to kind of bury that hook in there really good when you're using these two rods for your active baits. See if I can do more hand movements all around here. You there, over there, here. I'm such a nerd. But a nerd who likes to fish.
Here comes one. Cruising in fast, here he comes. It's coming.
Bam, that, oh, I lost him. So you gonna give me another chance? Oh, Clayton, oh, there's one on the bottom coming here. Pound, oh, he's coming in fast, here comes. Oh, he ate it. I should have kept pounding, I would have noticed whether he ate it or not. It's where I'm sitting here, it's so far away, I can't see the screen very, very good. Oh, I lost him.
Oh, there's a fish to the live minnow. I'm gonna see if he'll come over here to more active. That's another nice fish. Oh, he ate it.
Nice. Wow. Man, some days the live minnow is the ticket. Some days he's coming right at me. Some days it's the active bait. He's coming up so fast. Oh, he came up charging. It's another quality walleye. Oh, look at that. He spit up my live minnow too. Huh? Thanks, buddy. Should I use him again? Man, been super quality fish right now. Like so many, between like 18 to 22 inches so far today. It's been awesome. Good bite right now. Another quality fish. Golden walleye, baby. Oh, see you, buddy. I dropped him. Don't drop him. Don't drop the fish, Clayton.
Fish going to the live minnow. Is he going to come over here? Oh, no, he's definitely going to the minnow. He's underneath it right now. He's coming up to it. Oh, there you go. Just grabbed it.
Yeah, he's on it.
Yeah.
Nice. Well, 4:15. Had a little bit of a lull since our last flurry of fish there, but it's starting to get that prime time. I'm going to obviously try to fish with the underwater camera for as long as I can. I'm just pulling him out of the hole like that just because I'm going to keep him. So I'm not too worried about it. He's my second lunch fish, supper fish of the day here. Another good little eater right there. Like I said, I am going to fish with the underwater camera for as long as I can, but as soon as I lose visibility, I'll be going straight onto the mega live and focus on that. Not that I won't have both of them kind of in the video anyway, because the live minnow strikes haven't been on the underwater camera, so we'll be kind of switching up back and forth. Oh, I've got fish coming in here fast. Look at this right now. I'm gonna go to the dinner bell, see if I can draw them over, but I have a feeling they're gonna crush that live minnow right away. Oh, swarm of them. Here we go. Prime time, baby. All of a sudden, marks everywhere. It's like 5-6 fish down there. They're all around the live minnow too. It's three on the camera itself. Oh, it's come up to it, but don't eat it. Come on. This is crazy. Oh, he's turning on it. Come on. Yep, got him. Nice. Took a little bit. So look at that. As soon as I caught him, caught this one, they all just spooked out of there, right? Like, fish are spooky. Definitely. Definitely spooky. Okay. So sunsets in 20 minutes and I still got fairly good visibility on the underwater camera. I'm impressed. I know some people are always curious how I record on underwater camera, and there's two ways to do it. I have my way right here. I use an AverMedia recorder. That thing has to be hooked up to a power source though, and you have to have a memory card in there, HDMI cord, hooks up to the Aqua Vu and records. Aqua Vu has now come out with
a little bit of an easier way for everybody to record. You still need two different cords. You need the HDMI cord, which will hook up to here. This is called an AV connect. And then you need another cord to hook up into your phone or your tablet. But this is actually a power brick right here itself. So then you can record to your phone or your tablet and you can share the clips right from there. Much, much easier than having to go through an editing program like I do with the Aver Media Recorder. So they have these on their website. If you want to record from the Aqua Vu, I'm running an Aqua Vu HD 7i Pro. It's my favorite camera for sure. Out of all the ones that I use, I just had a mark come through here. It's my favorite camera to use out of all the ones I've used in the past. It's my favorite one. Like I said, there's a link below that'll take you right to the Aqua Vu site to get any of that fun stuff. But, oh, here he comes. Here he comes. I'm losing light down here slowly. I got 10 minutes before the sunset here, so still decent visibility, but as that sun sets, you're obviously gonna lose your visibility down there. So we're definitely crushing some fish here in prime time, baby. I'm telling you, typical Lake of the Prairies. Don't leave the ice too early if you can help it. If you gotta be safe to get off, leave early, it is what it is. We've caught some giant fish today. I'd be more than happy with that kind of a day. Look at this. As soon as I drop down, three more fish. Like, are you kidding me? I'll pull it up again, because sometimes when it gets darker, they feed better going up. Come on. Okay, I don't want you anyway. You're the smaller out of the couple. I'm losing visibility pretty bad here, so I'm probably gonna pull this camera right away and just fish off the Mega Live. Okay, I am gonna pull up that camera now. I got bad visibility, so we'll get that out of the water and just fish with the Mega Live. Look at this fish up higher. Look at this. Look at this. Oh yeah. Yeah. Come on. Come on. That's a nice fish. That is a nice fish. Maybe I shouldn't. There's another one coming from the bottom. Oh, I don't want this fish. I want that other one. I'm going to drop it past and see if I can get that bigger one. There's another one coming on the bottom too. That higher mark was better. Oh, look at this racing in. Unbelievable. Come on. Still not that other one though. That other mark was bigger, but I think it left. Wow. Okay. I love watching these fish on Mega Live. It's awesome. Oh, mark going right over to the live minnow. Look at that. It's going over to it. It's going to go thump. Thump. Come on, eat it. Decent fish. I'm not even moving the dinner bell until he... Okay, he kind of swam off, so I'm going to move it. It's going to come over here. Oh. He is really, really... definitely circling that live minnow. It's scared. Oh, it's coming over the dinner bell. Come on. Yep, nice. That's a better fish. Not giant, but better. It circled that live minnow for a long time. And then finally came over the dinner bell and ate. Nice fish. Not giant, but definitely good quality. It came up fast and trying to let it do its thing. I had to reel quick because it was just coming up. Power the hook set, right? I'm kidding. You do have to give it a good hook set when they're up biting though. Quality fish. Come on, baby. Nice. Easy. We got you. Nice golden fish right there, baby. Unbelievable. I'd take fish like that in a heartbeat all day. And back down she goes. Nice, like 23 incher, probably something like that. I run a little bit lighter line on the drench. 6 pound smoke show, I'm running 8. True Grit, I'm running 10. It's all Sufix 832 ice braid. I like their ice braid stuff. It's been really good. And then I match it with fluorocarbon leaders, 6, 8, and 10 in Sufix advanced fluorocarbon. It's been really, really good for me so far. I tried it this open water season, and now I'm using it in the ice fishing season. And so far I haven't had anything break off, which is what you want, right? You don't want any break-offs. Well, it's 5:44 p.m. It's been pitch black for about 25-30 minutes here. I still got some marks coming in. I'm still catching some fish, but I think it's time to pack up, head to the cabin. I got fish to clean, got fish to cook. I'm excited. I love being here right now. It's so good. Lake of the Prairies, Lost Meadows Resort. There's a link below if you want to go stay there this winter. Just keep in mind that Lowen books up pretty quick, so if you want to stay here this winter, you better book now. You can fish right from the place. You don't have to trailer like we did today. There's amazing fishing right from this place, especially as you start to get more ice on the lake. You can even travel from there as well. So that will wrap up this video. Thank you so much for watching. Today was an official Slay Day, definitely. So let's release the new Slay Day merch right now. It'll be available at the Teespring. I'll make sure that it's available here. It'll be my merch for December, Slay Day. Yeah, I think it's time to release it. Thank you everybody for watching, and don't forget, get outside.